right, welcome back to Atlanta Company. Thank you for watching. I'm Tom Sullivan. Catherine Bigelow's upcoming thriller, The Hurt Locker. It's a powerful, in-your-face, raw film that follows a group of men who are part of the U.S. Army's Explosive Ordnance Disposal Unit. They're called EODs, as they battle each other and defuse bombs on the deadly streets of Baghdad. Now, these are kind of like firefighters to a fire. EODs are the first call to the scene. James Renner is Staff Sergeant Will James. He's here to talk about this film. How are you, man?
Welcome. Yeah, fantastic.
We may get to know each other in the green room, but I got to tell you, I literally was not expecting what I saw yesterday on screen. I had to literally go home and have some moonshine, you know, and just not that I drink
Tennessee moonshine.
Tennessee shy, because I just had to gel out and zen and return to a sense of normalcy, because this is really dynamic. Talk about this film, The Hurt Locker.
Yeah, it's, you know, a lot of people have that reaction. I have that particular reaction. I need like a whiskey afterwards. But, it, you know, because it's you get involved in it. It's an experience. To me, it's unlike all the other blockbuster movies happening out there, not that I'm not downing like Transformers or any of those other movies, because those are just popcorn, check your brain at the door kind of movies. This is something that you partake in. It is a full-on experience. It's a visceral, you know, hit you hard, and you know, it's pretty fantastic.
I saw you on screen. I didn't know much about you personally as an actor, but I'm watching your character, Staff Sergeant Will James, and you're going in there and you're cocky and you're a loose cannon.
Yeah.
You know, but you've defused over 873 bombs.
Right.
How were you selected for the film?
Catherine, I think she saw this movie I did called Dahmer. And she thought that I'd be right for this role for whatever reason. And then we talked about it for, you know, several hours over the phone, kind of the ideas I had, and then we kind of just went from there. A year later, we started shooting.
You know, the leads in the film are pretty much unknown big, you know, names in Hollywood.
All emerging like, actors, yeah.
Yeah, like and myself. I kind of like that because, see, I didn't really know you from previous work, so I couldn't find comfort with you from like, oh, I know him because he was in so-and-so, and I... But because it always had me on the edge of my seat.
Right, right. Know? I think there was clever casting that way, to put like the main leads with three fresh emerging faces, and then just, I don't want to give too much away,
but
you put the familiar faces in, and then they might go away or might not. But so anyone is at risk at any given moment.
Yeah,
so.
Talk about some of your co-stars in the film.
Well, familiar faces you guys will know will be like Guy Pearce, mm-hmm. who's phenomenal, love this dude. Ralph Fiennes, mm-hmm. David Morse, Evangeline Lilly,
right,
who plays my wife, and then you know the other two main guys who are really some of the best actors I've ever worked with, Anthony Mackie and Brian Garrity.
Yeah, so. You guys have an incredible dynamic on screen together. The chemistry is like you guys are really EODs.
Yeah.
How did you prepare for this? I mean, where did you go to learn? Because it looks like you really know what you're doing.
Well, you know, people ask me all the time, you know, could you really defuse a bomb? I'm like, yes, but I wouldn't. I'd run the other way. There's no way I wouldn't get near one, even though I know how. I got to spend a lot of time with EOD in Fort Irwin, which was an absolute blessing. They taught me everything I know, and I wish I could remember half of the things.
Because mm-hmm. You were telling the set director, it goes, no, you can't use this wire, because you know it's going to be this
right,
kind.
Right, yeah, it was very, very specific stuff, and I wish I had someone there to tell me, you know, or this has someone else need to do that job so I can do mine, but I was glad I could... I knew a little bit that I needed to know.
So you got clearance to go on the Army base then and really, you know, train with some EODs, perhaps.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
What do you think the Army's take is on this film?
You know, I don't know. I hope they're, you know, I'm sure anyone can, if you put a microscope over anything, that you could pick it apart, you know. People will, but we tried to be as accurate as we possibly could to EOD because we respect them so much. The courage and what they're doing, they're saving our asses right now.
Yeah, for real.
And no one knows who they are.
They don't.
They're the unsung heroes right now of this conflict that we're in. So I hope that they walk away thinking, you know, that it's pretty fantastic. It puts them in a great light because they have a really, you know, great spot in my heart.
Mm-hmm. I was going to say, how did the film touch you personally? Because it really touched me. I have a buddy of mine, Major Woolley, who's in Iraq right now. And,
right.
You know, knowing people who work at Forcecom and kind of have a more awareness of our men and women. How did it touch you personally?
Yeah, it certainly makes, the awareness is just heightened in me. Especially, again, I can only speak really about EOD because mm-hmm. that's what I spent really so much time doing. So even if I'll be in an airport, and that's certainly shifted how. I'll go up and talk to them. Before just thinking like, oh, that's so cool, whatever, and now I certainly go out of my way to say, I just want to say thanks, or then I look at a patch, see if it says an EOD or not.
So, you know, this is taking place supposedly in Baghdad, but you guys shot this in Jordan, right?
In Jordan, right.
And it looks like, you know, being a low-budget film, I mean, mm-hmm. what were some of the pitfalls, you know, things that, roadblocks that you came across with not a lot of money for
funding?
Yeah,
well, you know, some of the guns we had, you know, probably see some clips that it's not a real gun. That's a soft pellet gun.
Really?
With the orange tips, we had to spray paint it black. It was hard to get some of the guns that we needed in the beginning. And then there's a sniper scene where we're shooting. We only had a few bullets, blanks to shoot, so we had to be very careful how many we actually shot.
Yeah.
Explosives. We're doing a movie with, you know, about bombs, about things that explode.
Sure.
And we can't get explosives into the country. It's, you know, it was very difficult. So we used Chinese fireworks. Ran into some issues with that. You know, you're rubbing, you know, two, you know, things of fireworks together in the heat and the rocks, and it blew up in a guy's face, unfortunately. And it's.
Did you learn a lot from what EODs really go through? Because as I'm watching this, it seems like, you know, the insurgents plant these bombs, and then everyone just stands around to watch how, if they can defuse them before. And then there, one guy in the movie is videotaping for YouTube, you know?
Yeah.
It just seems like a game.
Yeah, absolutely. It's cat and mouse.
Yeah.
It's a chess game with human lives.
So, you know, I was surprised to see that at the end of the film, because this film is loaded with testosterone, you know, that it's, and there's not many women really who do this line of work.
Right.
But this was directed by Catherine Bigelow, a female director. So what was it like working with her?
She's pretty hands off, you know, as far as like directing. And most of the direction was really sitting over like this, talking.
Yeah.
Just have a cup of coffee, a glass of wine, a salad or whatever, and just talk about getting on the same page of what we think the movie is, what the character is, where we're going with it. And then she just kind of hides like a ninja with her cameras there everywhere.
I bet.
And you just never saw them. So, you know, she's smart. She's very soft-spoken and tough as nails.
Mm. Well, it's a dynamic film, and I hope a lot of people see it.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, I mean, people have to go see it. They just have to see it.
It's one of those films that you got to put on your must-see list. It's not the most pleasant film, you know, but it's certainly one that brings to attention to what's going on overseas that we need to let everybody know about.
Yeah.
Hey, man, it's a pleasure.
Hey, man, thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
Hey, The Hurt Locker opens nationwide tomorrow. Put it on your must-see list. It's fantastic.